We've been talking about TSH, free T3, and free T4, and how those can be impacted by different things that might be going on in your body. This video today is about prescription medications that you might be taking for your thyroid and things that can make them not work well. Maybe they're not the right kind of medication, or things you might be taking that interact with them. So, as a reminder, we've been talking about how TSH stimulates the thyroid to make T4, and then T4 converts to T3 through the liver, and that's what our cells can use. Now, most of us are broken at that conversion from T4 to T3. And in these videos, I've been explaining ways that that could be happening and the testing that I like to use to uncover those problems. Now, most commonly, if you go to the doctor, they will check your TSH and they will say that is normal. Remember, their range is from 0.5 to 5. And if you're anywhere above 1, it suggests that your thyroid isn't working great. So if you're around 3 or 4, they might say you're normal. Well, let's say that you go over that 5 mark, excuse me, and now you're at 5 or 6. At that point, the doctor will probably prescribe a T4 medication. So the most commonly prescribed medication in the United States of thyroid category is Synthroid or levothyroxine. Those are T4 only medications. So you swallow the pill. Now you absorb the T4, but here's the problem. If you're broken at the conversion from T4 to T3, well, then you're not going to feel any better and your symptoms will probably stay the same. I see this happen with so many clients. So you'll go back to the doctor, they'll pull your labs, your T4 level will look pretty darn good because you're taking a T4 prescription. And oftentimes they'll check the TSH again, that number will probably be better. They'll maybe check the T4, that number will be pretty stable, but they don't check the T3. And that's where we need to uncover whether that T4 is actually converting to T3. And most commonly I see that it's not. So if you're on a T4 only med, it could be an issue with not converting it to T3, which is the active form. Again, how we know if you are converting is to use a thermometer. I talked about it in the video where we discussed T3. If you use a thermometer and check your temperature first thing in the morning, you can see if your temperature is up to par. If it's not, it could be that you're not converting the prescription well. Another thing that I see very commonly is that women take the Synthroid or the levothyroxine at the same time as all of their other prescriptions. That will make the prescription not be absorbed. So calcium is a big one you need to stay away from. It will bind to your thyroid prescription and then it will disable it from being absorbed. Iron will do the same. Antacids will do the same, including prescription antacids. Those are any PPIs or things like omeprazole or Prevacid or any acid reducers will do that. And then if you take it at the same time as your multivitamin, biotin can suppress absorption of that too. So Synthroid, levothyroxine, and if you're taking any other form, Armour Thyroid, WP, Westroid, NP, they do need to be taken alone and at least 45 minutes to an hour. Check with your doctor and pharmacist on this to see how long you should wait before taking any other medications or eating. I can't prescribe on medications. I can just share with you what I know. So be sure to check with your doctor and pharmacist if you want to make any changes on your timing or on your prescriptions. So taking them with other supplements, I see that as a common mistake. So be sure to wake up, take your prescription, and then wait an hour before eating or taking any other supplements. The next thing I see is frequently women will take it with hormones. So if you're taking it the same time as a birth control pill or estrogen and progesterone, those will counteract each other. So you cannot take it the same time as prescription hormones. It can interact with antidepressants, with anti-anxiety. So don't take it the same time as those. Again, as I said before, it can interact with antacids, with different gastrointestinal type prescriptions. So the takeaway here is talk to your doctor and your pharmacist. And in most cases, you need to take the thyroid medication all by itself. Now, this can be a problem for some of us who take supplements or have other prescriptions. So sometimes it is an option to move your thyroid prescription to bedtime. And that is something, again, talk to your doctor and pharmacist. But during my 28 years of taking thyroid medication, there was a good like 5-year stint where I took mine at night and it worked great. It actually absorbed better. I felt better. That was a good solution for me. And some of my clients do the same and some of them have a really good result. So know that's an option too. If you have like really rushed, busy mornings and you can't time it right, well, then maybe moving it to the evening if your doctor or pharmacist approves that. The other big thing that will inhibit absorption is coffee. So I see that happen a lot. Women will take their thyroid pill with a sip of coffee and that will inhibit the absorption of it, decrease your ability to absorb that pill. So those are the things to note. Now, one of the biggest reasons thyroid pills don't get absorbed is because they're bound by something called cellulose. And that is a very, it's a tight structure fiber from plants. And this is true of synthroid, it's true of levothyroxine, it's true of many of the natural desiccated thyroids. Desiccated thyroid is a category of like Armour, Naturethroid, NP, WP, Westthroid. So they are derived from pigs and then they're bound to the cellulose. And that's how we get the hard tablet. Now, that tablet requires a ton of stomach acid to be able to break apart and absorb in the body. And when you have a thyroid problem, you frequently don't make enough stomach acid. So another trick that I often tell women is you can try taking your thyroid medication with a little bit of lemon juice. So just squeeze some lemon in water and drink that. That will actually help the pill dissolve and then you can absorb it a whole lot better. So if you are taking these medications and not really noticing a difference, number one, try moving it away from anything else that might be interacting with it, any pills or supplements or coffee. And then you can try doing some fresh squeezed lemon juice in a glass of water at the same time you take your pill. Try that. When I made that switch, it was like, whoa, I'm absorbing this better. This is fantastic. And I was feeling so much better. So try that because it might just be that you're not breaking the pill apart in your stomach. So those are a couple of tips. I want to talk about the difference between medications because those T4 only medications, they will stay in your blood for 2 weeks. So if I take a pill today, there will still be some evidence of that 2 weeks from now. So it takes a long time to clear out of the body. Free T3, and that is what's in your combination medications, those desiccated Naturethroid, Armour Thyroid, NP, West PWP, those medications have T4 and T3. So the T4 in that pill will stay in your blood for 2 weeks. The T3 gets used up in 12 hours. So when it comes to T3 prescriptions and medications, be aware that they get utilized a lot faster. So you need to be consistent with your dose, consistent with the time of the dose. And that's also true of Cytomel, which is a T3 only medication. That one will be used in your blood very rapidly. Some pharmacies will compound those to make them slow release. And if that's the case, fabulous. But when it comes to either a combination medication or a T3 only medication, the T3 part does get used rapidly. So be sure to be consistent. Take it at the same time every day. Okay. I think those were all of my thoughts. Drop your questions below. If you have questions on your prescriptions, on what your, what actually comprises your prescription. Again, I can't advise on prescriptions, but I can tell you from my experience, what I know, what I've seen from my clients' experience. And I am always an advocate of talking to your pharmacist because they are the best educated on prescriptions and how they work in the body and things you can't take them with. So drop your questions below and I will talk to you soon.